أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربي أودعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. My dear brothers and sisters in Iman, Alhamdulillah, we're almost at the end of Ramadan, and this is a time where the believer will reflect and think about the day that passed. Here we are at the beginning of Rajab, turning to Allah and thanking Him for allowing us to live during Rajab and Sha'ban, and to beg of Him to give us that permission, that idhn, to be able to live during Ramadan. And Alhamdulillah, we're living it. But the question is, what are we gaining out of it? For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعُ وَالْعَطَشِ. Perhaps there is somebody who fasted, but they will gain nothing of their fast, only hunger and thirst. That means they haven't done that which will give them the position whereby they can excel to be among those whom Allah will choose to be among the righteous. Today, what I'm going to talk about is really essential and important, especially with the fast-moving world and the expanse of the people of Islam all over the world and the means of information and dissemination of information across the globe. And that puts somebody like me, as a da'iya and others, in a position whereby sometimes we meet people or we hear things that are not really from the teaching of our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, nor it is from the right inheritance that we inherited from the people of the Quran. Allah said in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل إن هذه سبيلي. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this is my path. أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة. I invite to Allah, but with an open heart. An open heart that is settled, peaceful, tranquil, strong, full of iman. Nothing else but Allah in that heart. Not just for Him. أنا ومن اتبعني. I and those who will be following me. وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين. And glory be to Him, Allah. And I am not one of those who take partners with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This, for me, is very clear that the people who will stand up to invite people to Allah are people whom Allah has chosen and bestowed upon them the understanding of how to do this job. When sometimes we look at people talking, sometimes they say things like, for example, one speaker will insult another speaker, one sheikh is putting another sheikh down, and all this friction and fitna. And who's at loss? The majority of the people of the world who are searching and yearning to turn to Allah, whom their messenger physically has left this world over 400 years ago. Over 1400 years ago, he had left the world. But he left for them his Quran, his eternal miracle, and his wisdom. And men and women who followed him, who did the best of jobs. And the only thing they had is the light of knowledge, the understanding of that knowledge. Allah says, advising him, ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن. O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, invite people to my way by the gentle reminders and the means of wisdom. And when you argue your case, always use that which is better. Because there is no fighting, hatred, rancor in the heart of that one who believes, especially the one who is disseminating the knowledge. Why? إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ أَعْلَمْ بِمَنْ ضَلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Allah knows those who are in error. Remember, he says to Sayyidina Muhammad, إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَهْدِ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. You will not guide those whom you love, because Allah is the guide. anyone who's trying to give out that beautiful invitation, he's only giving out the message on behalf of the messenger. And he must give it the way he was instructed to do himself. For Allah, huwa a'lamu bil muhtadin, wa huwa a'lam. He knows who were guided, who are guided, and who will be guided. However, he warns, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلْ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. However, among mankind, there are those who will argue without knowledge. And that's a sad thing. وَلَا هُدًى وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ. Not even the real means of guidance, nor a lighted message from the book, the Holy Quran. And therefore, Rasulullah sallam, one of the things that he always emphasized upon about himself, not just being a knowledgeable, wise, learned human being, no, a teacher. He says, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ مُعَلِّمًا. I was only sent to teach. To teach what? To teach the message that he was ordered to deliver. And Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu reported, Allah Rasulullah sallam, the messenger of peace be upon him, says, لا يدل الناس بخير. People will always be in a good shape. Everything will be all right. ما أخذوا العلم عن أكابرهم. As long as they take the knowledge from those who learned before them through the chain of knowledge, authenticated chains. فإذا أخذوا العلم من أصاغرهم هلكوا. But if they take the knowledge from those who are not in that chain, they will be destroyed. Allahu Akbar. So everything has to be authenticated. As when we talk about hadith, it has to be authenticated. And usually the hadith is da'if, it's because of someone in the chain. But in today's world, too many people are trying to disseminate this knowledge. Sometimes they don't know even where it came from. And even if they know, if you ask, they don't understand how. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also warned, إِنَّ هَذَا الدِّينِ عِلْمٌ. This religion is only knowledge. فَانْظُرُوا عَمَّنْ تَأْخُذُونَ دِينَكُمْ. Always be aware. Be awake from where you take your religion. I'm just saying this because I see a lot of the youth and the young people rushing, eager, but they fall just like the little insect that flies around the fire. They rush to it for the light, not knowing that the flames could eat them. Or the wildebeest in the jungle, running, rushing for water, coming out of the depths of dryness. When they fall into the rivers, they arrive, not knowing that crocodiles who are hungry for the last 6 months, waiting for their arrival, only to be destroyed and eaten. Don't you remember only yesterday, a lot of our kids were mesmerized by those who are speaking of the right of giving da'wah for them to Jannah and the hoor that are with them and the cream of our children from colleges, universities, even schools, 15 years old. Although they say no woman can travel without a mahram, but those little young innocent kids, little girls are allowed to come to them and they marry them one after the other. And then they take the innocent people who have been there for a long time as Ahlul Kitab, Ahlul Dhimma, and forcing them to slavery and making their women as sabaya to be abused. One of them will have 6, 7, 10 girls, some of them underage. And our girls who left from all over the world are a wife, divorce one, get one. What is this? This is because the da'iyah was not really in the path of da'wah that is permitted. Allah said to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Inna arsalnaka shahidan, mubashiran wa nadhira, wa da'iyan ila Allahi bi'idhnihi. We have sent you as a da'iyah By Allah's permission. Do you think Allah will give permission for somebody to destroy when He is asking us to build? Not just to build the dunya, to build the people faith, to love Him. But that can never be achieved without loving His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, إِنَّهُ لَا يَقُومُ بِدِينِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا مَنْ حَاطَهُ مِنْ جَمِيعِ جَوَانِبِهِ. None will be able to carry this faith properly, only those who understand it fully. If only those people who yesterday called for our children to come to establish the heaven of the earth and the Khilafah, that they thought they are Ahlul Laha, they are its people. Our children today sitting in camps, neither our government are allowing them to come back home, nor the place where they are in is willing to take them for the turmoil and the fight. And Rasulullah sallam have warned of this. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned some of us who will be emotional about these issues. He said, La tabku ala deen. Don't cry over the religion. The deen is deenullah. La tabku ala deen idha wulliyuhu ahlahu. If the people of the religion, of the knowledge, are looking after it, don't cry over it. وَلَكِنْ أَبْكُوا عَلَيْهِ إِذَا وُلِّيهِ غَيْرَ أَهْلِهِ. When the people who are not really Allah's people, nor the people of knowledge, nor the authenticated people of learning the knowledge in the chain, عَنْ to Rasulullah sallam, then you should cry. And how many mothers have cried for their little kids who were taken from the midst of their degrees, their school exams. And what happened? Death, destruction, and a loss. While we are awake, unable to do anything. And you know why? Because sometimes within ourselves, we approve those things. Our hatred to the modern life sometimes, to the Western world that conquered our country for years, for the hypocrites that are ruling our countries perhaps, and the corruption and everything, we are blinded. Because we're not really doing it for Allah. We're doing it for ourselves. Didn't you hear? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only accepts that which is done for His sake. The intention must be right. And finally, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبُضُ الْعِلْمَ انْتِزَاعًا. Allah will not take this knowledge by forcing it out of our hearts. من العباد, from those who are worshipping Him, وَلَاكِنْ يَقْبُضُ الْعِلْمَ بِقَبْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Knowledge is taken away by taking the righteous, knowledgeable, authenticated scholars of the earth. حَتَّى إِذَا لَمْ يَبْغَ عَالِمًا. Until when there is none of those authentic ulama or righteous scholars are there, اتَّخَذَ النَّاسُ رُؤُوسًا جُهَالًا فَسُئِلُوا فَأَتَوْ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ فَضَلُّوا وَأَضَلُّوا. Then people will follow, perhaps women, perhaps men, whom they will make them their head, and inviting people to Allah and making da'wah and teaching them. But they are ignorant. Then they will ask, and then they will answer without knowledge. They went astray for themselves, those who answer without knowledge. But indeed, Allah, they have misled many. That is my message. Please, those days when you are locked in, ask yourself, did this ever happen before? Why are we locked in? What is happening to us? What can I do? Don't say there is no answer. The answer lies within. Allah says, He will never change people until people change themselves. And you are one of the people. I am one of the people. We need to change ourselves. We need to stand upright. And we need to take knowledge from the right place. Not just stay into Google and any website. There is an answer in it and take it. Sad that will be if that website we're getting our answers. Indeed, behind it is not a rightful human being who is scholarly given the gift of knowledge, but an enemy of Islam, of our faith, of Rasulullah sallam, عرف الله. Think about that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guard me and guard you. Protect me and protect you. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا ونورا ساطعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء والغنى عن الناس. يا رب اشرح صدورنا، يسر أمورنا، آتنا سؤلنا، بلغنا مقصودنا، زدنا علما وزدنا فهما واجعلنا من الراشدين. يا رب هيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا واجعل معونتك الحسنى لنا مددا، بالأولياء بالصالحين بجمعهم، من جاءنا القرآن عنهم مرشدا، فرج بفضلك إلهي كربنا يا خير مد الأنام له يدا. وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد وآله وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير الجزاء، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.